The growth in the solar industry has been remarkable. I mean, there's really no other way to describe it. 20 years ago, in the year 2004, the industry installed 1 gigawatt of solar. This year, we'll have 1 gigawatt installed in less than a day. So this exponential growth has led to a fast reduction in cost, making solar more accessible. There's no place on the planet that solar doesn't work and provide good value. So this is part of the success of solar. In fact, a report recently came out showing that solar and wind, other renewable technologies, have to triple before the end of this decade. And then, of course, have to triple again by 2050 to reach our net zero goals. So this means solar has to continue this amazing growth for some time because it's responsible for a significant portion of our emissions reduction, which is the goal of a lot of our energy infrastructure change. Technology is at the heart of the energy transition, and especially in solar, technology is core to how solar is manufactured, how it's deployed and where it's deployed, and even in how it's operating and interacting with the electrical grid and the home system. So I think there's really no other way to presume that solar or really the energy transition happens without innovation and technology at its core. So some of the hurdles in bringing any new technology to market is overcoming the inertia of change that's needed. And change is hard by nature, so true change has to create real value and also be simple. Because when change is simple, it becomes inevitable, and having change become simple also means that it's accessible. The thing that we think is the next big thing in solar energy that we're working on here at Hanwha Qcells is called perovskite tandem technology. And this is essentially the next generation of solar cell technology that's based on our conventional technology, which 95% of the world's solar is based on silicon-based technology. The innovation here is on top of this conventional silicon-based cell, we add a perovskite thin film layer. It's sort of a magic layer that captures a different spectrum of the sunlight than the bottom cell. So this combination of the top cell, thin film perovskite, the bottom cell, conventional, well-known silicon-based technology, combination is very compelling. It creates a next generation capability in terms of efficiency, breaks the limit of physics for a single junction alone, and it creates this whole new opportunity to expand solar with even more capability and low cost. Definitely going to be an exciting next step in the solar arena. By Hanwha Qcells. It starts with our historic focus on solar cells and solar modules. And this is really the first part of the chain of building energy from solar. It's when sunlight is transformed into electricity. This is very exciting technology. And even though this is technology that has been around for decades, there's constant evolution and advancements being made. The next segment of technology that we're working on is taking that electricity and transforming it into connecting in an electrical system, whether it's household or the electrical grid. There are power electronics and controls and a vast array of technology that allow that electricity to be useful. The next stage of technology that Hanwha Qcells is focused on is we're building the systems, the engagement of this electricity within the markets, within the operation of the grid, within the operation of the home, including software and hardware to create and extract more value from solar than ever before. AI will play a pivotal role in the energy industry and in the transformation of our energy systems. And fundamentally, AI does two things really well. First, collects a large amount of very diverse data and can bring this in. And secondly, it can use that data to make very quick and very complex decisions or generate next stages or planning. In the solar arena, we have a lot of data. In the energy space, of course, there's a lot of data. The use of artificial intelligence to harness that data, make decisions based on anything from the best use of multiple generating sources, the best timing to store or charge or discharge energy in a battery, even how to orchestrate a very complex grid. So without AI, we don't actually get to achieve the full energy transition. So data is at the core. Qcells is in a very good position to leverage AI. It's a very unique position. because Qcells has access to data that extends from manufacturing of the panels, operating of the electrical system, even installation of the plant, operating the home, running a virtual power plant, this entire network at residential, commercial, and utility scale. And Qcells has the most broad and the deepest well of data in the world. There's no other place that has this data set under one roof. So being able to extract value from this data and even using the decisions and the insights from this data to make our specific capabilities even better will become part of how we operate. And it's a very unique opportunity for Qcells. There are some fundamental barriers that the entire solar industry is focused on addressing or highlighting. The first is the need for increased transmission. It's most efficient and low cost when it's also centralized, like a large scale solar plant. But we can only build more of those when we can take that energy and bring it to the people that need electricity. So the ability and the limitations of our current grid are very stark. The second piece is creating value of solar, very accessible, but it's also limited to when you have access to a good energy resource, sunlight. The unique barrier that Qcells is addressing is the volatility of our supply chains. As regions become more dependent and more interested in bringing low-cost, high-reliability solar technology, they need to have access to a supply chain for this material that is not impacted by climate change and weather events or geopolitical disruption. So Qcells is focused on creating domestic supply chain in regions where there is solar growth to create a much more smooth access and consistent access to this technology. So today, there's almost a billion people on the planet that have no access to energy, and far more that have no access to affordable or clean energy. And you know, energy is the backbone of economic development, security, health, prosperity. And solar is the key to unlock this. There's nowhere on the planet that doesn't have good access to solar energy. And what my hope is for how Qcells realizes this vision to provide energy for all is that we can create this access to low-cost energy that's very affordable and very reliable, because this will change the world. My hopes for COP29 this year is that we continue to see pledges and obligations being formalized, but that we also see a narrowing of the gap between the pledges and the actual policy that is implemented. It is a great thing for governments around the world to highlight their focus and their intention. It won't matter unless they also follow up with the policies that support their intention. The thing that keeps me and my team at Hanwha Qcells going is the idea that we're changing the world. This is a big challenge that we're a part of, working with a network of the global community. There will be setbacks and there will be challenges, but part of the joy in this is seeing the results and making the next steps. So those always will outweigh the challenges along the way, but our optimism is rooted in seeing the impact that we can make.